It's time to once again revisit the world of the Evil Within, my friends. Welcome back. This walkthrough is going to be played on the hardest difficulty of the game, AKUMU Difficulty. In this difficulty setting, if you are hit just once, you'll die. So obviously this is going to be a no damage walkthrough, and most importantly it's going to be a no deaths walkthrough. And my plan is to show you how to approach each chapter without taking any damage, and obviously without dying. I will also be showing the location of all the collectibles and all the keys, for those of you who are struggling a little bit in finding a specific collectible or key. So I'll let you witness the intro of the game now, and I'll be back once the gameplay starts.
Went out just before I picked you up, said it was multiple homicides. Half a dozen units already on scene.
131, please advise.
Maybe it's the ghost of that doctor who went schizo and chopped up all those patients.
That's not what happened. Some patients disappeared. Some kind of scandal?
Still, gives you the creeps, doesn't it?
127, 124, please respond.
Joseph, you think there's a connection?
It's a possibility. I believe the records were sealed.
Anyone on scene, respond.
Dispatch, this is Detective Castellanos in 184. What's the situation? Over.
184, be advised. Some problems with Chimon's son at the Beacon Memorial.
Is there any...
God damn it! Jesus!
Junior Detective Kidman. Any thoughts?
Nothing yet. I'm sure we'll know everything once we get there.
Contact dispatch and let them know what's happening. Joseph, Kidman, you're with me. We're gonna have a look around.
Right.
Okay, let's do this once again. Some of you might be wondering why I'm doing a walkthrough for the Evil Within one more time. In my opinion, AKUMU Difficulty is pretty hard, and the way that you need to approach each chapter is very different compared to the approach that you would have on the easier difficulties. Plus, I said when I ended my walkthrough, my no damage walkthrough for survival difficulty, I promised that I would do a walkthrough on AKUMU difficulty. I was asked by a few people to do it as well, and I really feel that this walkthrough will be helpful to anyone that's struggling a little bit with AKUMU difficulty, since it's probably the hardest trophy to obtain in the Evil Within. And since my survival difficulty walkthrough for this game was pretty well received, and I read the comments and saw that a lot of people were using my walkthrough as a guide to complete their game, I figured that doing a walkthrough on AKUMU difficulty will be useful as well. Plus, I enjoy playing this game and I enjoy the challenge. And that's what walkthroughs are for. They're supposed to help people complete the game. At least that's what I do in my walkthroughs. So I hope I can deliver once. Here we have Dr. Jimenez.
Impossible.
On my survival difficulty walkthrough, I was told multiple times that you don't pronounce the J in his name. I called him Jimenez all the time, and I'm going to try and correct that this time, but I might exaggerate a little bit on my pronunciation.
What the hell?
back in control of Sebastian. Now the gameplay is officially going to start. We have to find our escape from this prison, but we're not looking too well right now. It does bring back memories though, being back in the room of the sadist, who's going to appear in front of us in just a second. He's a sneaky little devil, isn't he? And for the most part in this first part of this chapter, the game plays precisely the same way in whichever difficulty you play. However, a little bit further on, you'll notice that on AKUMU difficulty, there are a few things that are different, and as such you might be caught by surprise, but I got you covered. Cut the ropes and we fall onto the floor, and now all that we need to do is calmly approach the sadist, or the butcher, whatever you want to call him, and we have to pick up the keys that are standing right by his side. We just don't want to alert him, and we just have to wait until it moves away. There we go, pick up the keys. Again, this part plays precisely the same way as it played on survival difficulty, nightmare difficulty, or the casual difficulty. So you shouldn't have any problems here, up until this point at least. I found that Sebastian actually moves quicker if you use stealth movement. When he's ducking, he moves quicker than when he's standing normally, so. And move, and you'll be fine. And get ready to run here. I'm assuming that if you're watching the walkthrough on AKUMU difficulty, you probably have played the game at least once. Shit. All these things that I'm saying, you are already well aware of what's going to happen next. Nonetheless, if you aren't, just let me know, because I don't want to spoil the story for anyone ahead of time. And as such, if this is your first time watching the walkthrough, I'll try to be careful and not reveal any super important plot points as I move along. You have to move quickly here and jump down. Get ready to dodge to the left, because of these blades which will cut you into pieces, and then dodge to the right, so left, right, and you'll be fine, and land safely in this pool of blood and guts. Rather wonderful, isn't it? And it's funny to me how as soon as Sebastian gets out of this tank, all of a sudden his face, which was covered in blood and guts, all of a sudden is clean. Quite miraculous how that happens, but I guess I'm nitpicking a little bit. It would look too much like Carrie if he kept his face covered in guts and blood. If you haven't watched Carrie, then you might not understand that reference, but I'm sure most of you know Carrie. So we're going to obtain the first collectible of this chapter and the first collectible of the game right here. Once again, like I said at the start of this video, I will be showing the location of all the keys and all the collectibles. However, I won't take as much time to read them. So if you want to read the files, you can either watch my survival difficulty walkthrough, or you can just pause Where's the exit? And read it before moving ahead with the video. This isn't a speedrun of any sorts, but it just seems redundant to be reading the files once again. Like I said, my main objective for this walkthrough is to show strategies to approach each chapter. And now we're just going to calmly climb this ladder and pick up the second collectible in this chapter, which is another file. And after that, there's nothing else to pick up in this chapter. But we are going to up ahead encounter the first difference of AKUMU difficulty in comparison to other difficulties. So be prepared. To be honest with you guys, I was actually going to wait a little bit before I made my walkthrough for AKUMU difficulty, but since Resident Evil, the remake of Resident Evil in HD will come out on January 20th, I really want to have the Evil Within wrapped up before the release of the remake of Resident Evil, since I'm really looking forward to that game, and I'm going to dedicate all of my efforts for the game as soon as it's released. Plus Dying Light will also be released a little bit later on in the month, and I want to do a walkthrough for that game as well. So while things are a little bit more calm now, I'm going to try and complete my walkthrough on AKUMU difficulty for the Evil Within. Here comes the sadist once again. He doesn't give us a break. Well, I guess he was kind enough to let us reach this room in safety. So we're going to stay very quietly inside this locker and wait for him to move towards the next area. And once he moves, we'll be able to get out of the locker and advance in the chapter. For now, just remain still and patiently wait until he leaves. He's not very smart. And there he goes. So now we can calmly leave the locker and we're going to sneak past the sadist here. Just like in survival difficulty, pick up this bottle, throw it towards the entrance. The sadist will come and inspect, and as he moves past you, move ahead towards the next room. But now you'll notice a small difference. As opposed to survival difficulty, where you could sneak past towards the next area immediately, there's actually a box blocking this section here, so you need to pick up another bottle, just like I did, and throw the bottle in order to lure the sadist, and he will destroy the items blocking your path, and that way you will be able to progress towards the next area. So that's one of the differences in AKUMU difficulty, and I guess they did this on purpose. They thought that probably a person who played this on survival difficulty and then moved on to AKUMU difficulty would think that they could just throw a bottle and then escape the sadist, but in AKUMU difficulty, if you try to do that, your path will be blocked and chances are you'll be caught off guard by the sadist and end up dying. And you don't want that. I'm taking this bottle as a souvenir. Seeing Sebastian holding a bottle like this and dragging himself around, it almost seems like he's drunk. He's not, but it's still funny. But I guess I lost my bottle, which is a shame. And we are almost home free. And the first chapter is pretty much completed at this point. There's going to be a long cutscene up next, which I'm going to let you guys enjoy. Let's just make our sweet escape. We won't have to deal with the sadist for a while, thankfully. Until chapter 3, that is.
Darkness twisting me around. jokes tied in the noose.
We're back in control of Sebastian here. And now all that we need to do is sneak towards the exit of the hospital, and that will conclude this chapter. There's going to be another cutscene and it will be over. So I'm going to let you guys enjoy the cutscene in peace, and I'll be back once we're close to the ending of the cutscene. Just get out of the door and you're in the clear for now.
Just a few bumps, we're fine.
Fine. Fine. Fine.
We will be once we're far away.
Fine.
A little further and we'll be fine.
Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine. Fine.
Fall! Fall!
And we're going down. And just like that, the first chapter of the game is completed. Things are going to get a lot more difficult in the next chapter, that's for sure. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this walkthrough useful and that you follow it. Thank you for all the comments and likes, I really appreciate them. And I'll see you all later for chapter number 2. Take care, my friends.